Let's take a look at some information and charts on Balancer for Brave New Coin. So Balancer is a DEX AMM. So we can look at all the associated metrics with that. They are multi-chain on Polygon, Arbitrum, multi-version, V1, V2. And the general idea here is that these portfolios will rebalance automatically based on set parameters. So it's automated, right? You don't have to look at it or pay attention to it. It just does its thing. They say it's gas efficient. And you can also earn BEL as an incentive. So there's a use case for the token-ish. You know, I don't think it's perfect or fleshed out amazingly, but it's there. So if you're managing a portfolio or your own portfolio, you know, and you want to set specific parameters, you can do so. And then people can also participate in those portfolios based on the privacy settings you're using for the portfolio. And you can adjust that all on Balancer. As far as the trading aspects are concerned, it looks like every other DEX, which is great. Two clicks, you're in with through MetaMask or wherever, and you can trade just as you would any other DEX. If we look at the pools, this is where things look different than most exchanges. The percentages here aren't 50-50 or 33-33-33, whatever curve is, or uni, right? You can make this whatever you want. You can make it 10% BAL, 80% ETH, 10% BTC, right? Something like that. You could do whatever you want, and it would automatically rebalance the portfolio when it needs to. Now, the APRs also change based on what's getting staked and where, and if they have liquidity mining through BAL incentives turned on for that pair or not. So this is getting more and more complex on the back end of things. On the front end, you just see, you know, right, it's this APR, APY, and you go from there. But where that's coming from is getting more and more sophisticated, and certainly the AMM components are getting more and more sophisticated. And you can search this by tokens, and you get all sorts of weird stuff people are doing. The biggest thing is whether or not it's actually gas efficient and whether or not you're saving any money on the ETH chain. I haven't used Balancer enough personally to know that answer, but if somebody who has, let me know in the comments. Looking at the DEX stats through all the DEXs, Balancer here in the purple, so it's at less than 10% on the day. It's usually down there at less than 10% on the day, but above most other smaller slices here. It's never going to be Uniswap, Sushi, or 1inch, most likely. Those are really the big three right now. But that may change over time if people warm to the idea of different AMM percentages or unique, you know, unique sophisticated use cases, sort of niche for what you want to do and what you want to accomplish. On a weekly basis, Balancer here in the turquoise or whatever that is, it, you know, you're not going to notice it if it's gone, but it's definitely a noticeable slice on any given day. And then in the gray here on a monthly basis, its best month was May, along with most DEXs. That's slowly tailed off since May. Now, if we look at TVL on everything and we look for Balancer on the list, it is 15th at, according to DeFi Llama, 3.64 billion. And we can see the split here, Polygon, Arbitrum, and ETH. Most of that is ETH. Almost all of it is ETH. TVL is at an all-time high, though, across everything. So it's hard to be bearish on the protocol. The question is whether or not that'll translate into actual token accrual value. Oftentimes, you'll see spikes in TVL relative to the mining incentives. So they're actually giving away probably a ton of Balancer to incentivize the TVL. Now, what happens when that incentive is gone is the question. Do people actually stay on Balancer? Or do they just leave? If they're smart, they'll probably just leave because there's no incentive, right? They're going to go wherever there is the greatest incentive. So it's this give and take between you want TVL, but you don't want the incentives to be too high because then that'll hurt price of the underlying token. And we're seeing a lot of that in DeFi generally right now, I think. Like I already said, TVL all-time high. On V2, it's at 1.6 billion currently. Trading volumes all-time high on V2. Transactions basically flat since July. Users growing pretty significantly here, 4x in the past couple weeks. So it looks like it's becoming more popular than it was previously, certainly. I mean, if you just look at the user numbers, they were getting like 150 people a day. Now they're getting in the 800, 900 range consistently. So it's hard to be bearish on the protocol when you see that. Polygon stats diminishing a little bit. Volumes flat, transactions flat, users definitely flat. My guess is the incentives for Polygon deposits or AMM is gone compared to where it was. And Arbitrum all we can see at the moment are the users and contract interactions, which are down over the past couple of days. So really the big thing is the V2 user numbers. For me, that's massive to see actual lots of people using it compared to where it was. If we look at stats for the token itself, we have the transaction count in the line graph, average transaction values in the fill. The average transaction values aren't really going to tell you much because you're not really going to move Bell around frequently. And you can see that in the transaction count graph, which is at an all-time low currently, 330 transactions per day, which is nothing. That's probably just mining incentive people. So this could be effectively zero if you take out the mining incentives. Very few people are moving this stuff around. It's pretty much all spec. There's not really like a fundamental drive for on-chain activity here. If we look at NVT, a measure of economic utility relative to price, and then looking at active addresses also just straight down and to the right at around 200 active addresses per day, which is also nothing. NVT continues to rise and rise and rise, which makes sense because you're seeing very little on-chain activity relative to market cap. I don't think these metrics matter too much for price, as much as they matter for BTC and ETH. They really don't matter for DeFi stuff, that as far as I can tell so far, right? It's still kind of early. We still don't have that much data. You know, this is since June 2020. It's still a baby in diapers compared to what I'm able to do and look at for BTC with a 10-year history. And this is MVRV relative to price, another inverse or a metric of market cap versus on-chain activity. For most coins, this tops out at a 2x and correlates pretty well with all-time highs in price. For DeFi, even Balancer here, it doesn't really make too much sense, because if you're sort of selling at the apex of MVRV, you're kind of missing the rest of the price history here, the price discovery at all-time highs. All-time highs in price was a 0.96 for MVRV, so it doesn't really make any sense. That may change over time, but right now it doesn't really help you. And if we look at market cap versus annualized revenue, a PE ratio equivalent for the legacy people out there, Balancer's at a 26 multiple currently. There are several protocols with a better multiple. This just means market cap relative to revenue. So Sushi, Aave, Compound, and Uni all have better relative ratios there. Whereas Maker, Bancor, Curve, and Synthetix have much higher multiples relative to revenue. Generally, you want to be buying stuff in the left side of this graph relative to the right side. If you look at technicals for the token price, 5,200 EMA, VPVR, volume, RSI, and monthly pivots here on Binance. It's definitely been on the struggle bus since this breakdown here. At the time, it looked more like an ascending triangle to me than a rising wedge. It was kind of a mess for both of those things, but it didn't end up breaking down along with everything else. Double bottomed here, and then head and shouldered here, and then now it has this mini ascending triangle quality to it. So not a lot of chart pattern analysis at this point in time. It's really just trend analysis here that's probably going to win the day. If this thing can get a bullish 5,200 cross, price above the 200, above VPVR, probably somewhere around the $30 levels where that would end up being, then I like a move to the upside. It's not going to do it by itself. It's going to be along with all of DeFi. But this one is still kind of flat relative to where it fell off the table in May and June. So I do like 40 to 50 from 30 for the upside there. On the cloud, it is getting ready to be above the cloud with a bullish TK cross with a bullish cloud. That is probably 2 weeks away, if I had to guess. But if I was actively trading this, this would be on some alert list or watch list. Looking specifically, when does it start checking these boxes? When is it above the cloud? When do you get your TK cross? When is the cloud flipping bullish? So it's getting there. It's getting ready for potential continuation to probably at least 44 based on this 50% retracement, which is what this cloud level is. So I like 44. Beyond that, I'm not so sure. And it'll tell you probably around 27 to get in on the cloud there. Against BTC, it has, for the most part, done nothing but lose value. Did have this ascending triangle quality to it with a bull cross that ended up breaking down. But ever since then, it's just melting like a ice cube in the summer heat. Continually pushing all-time lows here. Kind of getting a bull div at the bottom. Maybe that's playing out now, but I'm not confident this does anything beyond a mean reversion attempt. This is not going to outperform BTC. The cycle, it may have a spike here and there towards the end of December, but I doubt this has a move that's significant against BTC. Tons of volume resistance on the upside. EMA resistance here at the 200 at 60K sats. So still looks significantly bearish. And against ETH, it also looks pretty bearish and has been bearish since, you know, since it got denied at the 200-day moving average in March. It's just been death ever since then. Low volume, continuous down. This is not a buy for me. I guess if you want to buy an all-time low and hope for a mean reversion to 0.01, that's probably fine. But I would avoid this if you're trading it relative to ETH. You're probably much better off just holding ETH at that point in time. Last, I'll just mention the ETH BTC fund and DeFi portfolio. I trade for Techme Capital on Enzyme.finance, a non-custodial portfolio management tool where you can send ETH or USDC or just watch what I'm doing. You can see everything, including AUM performance allocation, all the vaults I'm in here on Yearn Comp and Aave. You can see that I am holding a balancer here somewhere. Where's that? Where's the vault? Here we go. Aave interest-bearing balancer at a 7% allocation. Doing decent today, up 11%. And you can also see the trades in the trades tab down below. That's all over this one. Like, dislike, comment, share, subscribe, and happy trading.